The nails, or flechettes, as the manufacturer has labeled them, are carried aloft in these rockets by a Cobra gunship, each rocket packed with more than 2,000 nails, one of the deadliest anti-personnel weapons now in use. 10 rockets will carry almost as many nails as used to build a typical 3-bedroom ranch house with garage. The payload of 2 rockets can tattoo an area the size of a football field, probably wounding or killing everyone in the area. This is the delivery system for the flechettes for the nails.
Right. Now, the entire basic round consists of the motor, which is forward of the fins, to this particular point. From the dark portion up to this point is comprised of the nails and the charge that pushes the nails out of the tube when it does fire. When it fires, this cone moves off and the nails will disperse out into a pattern.
Now the nails are all packed very tightly in there. Maybe you could show us just what they look like.
That's one row of nails. There's about 6 rows up through this particular warhead.
Now, this is the red dye we see when the nails are fired.
Right.
What purpose does the dye serve?
The only purpose I know of is just so that they can tell that it has expended out the nose of the particular carrier here.
Correspondents are not permitted to fly actual combat missions in the gunship, but we were able to join Captain Bill Bunton on a maintenance run to check his weapon systems in a free fire zone.
Captain, what type of targets do you prefer to use your nails against?
What we prefer to use against the enemy personnel in the open is that they're the most effective. We also like to use them against the enemy in trees because the nails will penetrate the trees all the way to the ground where other rockets go off in the top of the trees.
A number of empty ammunition crates have been dumped into the area, and Captain Button will be firing at them.
Okay, we're making a very steep descent now, heading right down onto the target area.
Okay. First 2 rockets.
Puffs of red smoke. Another set of rockets. They're firing in pairs.
Okay, that's it.
2,200 nails in each rocket. Now we're pulling away from the target area. And you can see plumes of dust and smoke where the nails have impacted.
Often the nails will knife right through the target, although at certain angles they do have a tendency to tumble immediately on impact. And after piercing the skin, a tumbling nail can cause a gaping wound.
Bill, it looks as if this strip was the strip facing the chopper as we came in on it. And how many hits do you have here?
It looks like we got one that hit here, one in here, one in there, another one down here, and another one here, and another one down in here. It hit it pretty good along the side there.
Think that's pretty good shooting?
Yeah, I'm satisfied with it.
Nails are also used in artillery rounds called beehives and in shotgun shells, which are especially effective in response to a roadside ambush. In a war where Allied troops use laser beams to locate their targets, scopes that permit them to see in the darkness of night, computers to guide their jet bombers, it is rather unusual to find that nails, inexpensive, not quite an inch and a half long, something you could hang a picture on, are such an important part of the U.S. arsenal.
Those nails may have been one of the strangest weapons in Vietnam, but they were only one part of a huge arsenal of destruction.